What is going on, guys? Bengal again here, coming back at you with another episode of Jaguars Franchise. This is week 14. We got the Kansas City Chiefs. We've been on a crazy win streak. We're 10-2 now after two straight losses to start the year. And if you did not stay to the end of last episode, which I highly recommend you guys do, stay to the end, obviously, so you don't miss things. I did end up changing the sliders. They were pretty, like, against me already with pass blocking down super low, but they've been turned down even more. Pass blocking 30, run blocking 35. Our pass coverage was turned down even more, even though I feel like they've been scoring at a decent clip. It was really just about making it harder for us to score a bunch of points. So their pass defense reaction time was turned up a bit. Interceptions was turned up a bit. Pass coverage was turned up a lot. So it's 60-65 now. Should be a lot tougher to throw the ball. It's already tough to run the ball. So week 14 against the Chiefs should be, like, super not fun, but what a great time to test it out. Draft stories. We do have one this week, which is NFL Draft Preview. Wake Forest left end Stephon Terry had a pretty amazing game this weekend on the road. He's definitely climbing up my draft ... because they don't include the rest in the game. You just have to assume it's going to say draft board. It's frustrating. I hate he's climbing up your draft board. He's number one. That might be a new change, though. I think Manny Bass was previously number one. Anyway, the entire draft experience on Madden is garbage, in my opinion. But what are you going to do? It is what it is. Hit that subscribe button if you guys are new. And definitely please make sure to check out my second channel linked in the description if you're into watching me do other things than just play Madden. Like, GeoGuessr is on there opening real-life sports cards. Everyone always says, oh, I didn't know you had a second channel. I didn't know you streamed. Those links are in the description, coming up on 25,000 Twitter followers as well. So definitely make sure to check those things out if you are interested. I know not everyone is going to be, but if you are, please check it out. Glenn Lowry looks like decent value for the third round, even though he's an early third round player, projected to go third round. Looks to be pretty good, though. If you didn't watch last episode, we scored 62 points. Gardner Minshew had the best game of his career. The best game he's ever going to have, probably. He threw for 500 yards and 5 touchdowns. Didn't really get a ton of skill points in there. And it's shocking to me that after that unreal performance, he doesn't get a chance to go up to Superstar X Factor. It's disappointing. Those pop up so few and far between. It's maybe one a season if you're lucky, it seems. It was scaled back, toned back a ton from Madden 20. And it's just a little bit annoying, in my opinion. We do have some players to upgrade, but it's Luke Barkou and Greg Dortch. So, CPU can deal with that. I'm not super excited for this game, honestly. The Chiefs are a really, really good team. Tyreek Hill, Patrick Mahomes are going to be tough enough to stop, and then you throw in Travis Kelce and Clyde Edwards-Helaire and Mecole Hardman. It should be really, really tough as we're going to rock white pants and have a blast here in the all-whites. Ooh, Arrowhead is looking sharp. Andy Reid looking darker than I remember him. Maybe he's been at the tanning salon. I don't know. We had a night game. We got primetime action of two teams here late in the season that have combined for a lot of wins. 18 wins here in, I believe, week 14. So these are two of the best teams in the NFL, if you could not tell from, you know, 10 wins from us and 8 wins, respectively, from the Chiefs. Two really, really solid teams. And I am not looking forward to facing Mahomes. Mahomes facing pressure already. Just manages to get it away in the direction of Sammy Watkins. Not a bad start for our defense. It is only one play. 5 seconds have gone off the clock and that's it. As Sidney Jones has an interception. And Sidney Jones has a pick six. The worst player on the team. On defense, maybe. Actually makes a play. He intercepts Patrick Mahomes on his second throw of the game and takes it all the way back for 6. 7-0 Jags. We couldn't have had a better start to this game. Oh, their starting running back isn't even Edwards-Helaire. It's Damian Williams. That's interesting. Thought that CEH would have taken over at this point in time. I guess not. 2nd and 8. And that is a lob. And Sidney Jones, I thought he was going to get interception number 2 there. but it was not the case. You know, you'd think people would be telling me to turn up QB accuracy, just because that seems to be pretty low, and Mahomes is off to a bad start, but you see so many of these quarterbacks with QB accuracy where it is, you know, miss two or three throws the entire game on us and throw for 400 yards. Look at what Deshaun Watson did. Just an uncharacteristically bad start from Patrick Mahomes. Mahomes, is that Deadeye? Didn't seem to be that much on the mark there. They're not even going to get the first down. Oh, and now down 7, 4th and inches punt from the 47 from midfield. They're in our territory, and they're still going to punt. And they don't even get it inside the 20. What a weak decision. They deserve to lose after that. They straight up deserve to lose the entire game for one decision. We're waiting on that to develop. Over the head of the linebacker, D.D. Westbrook catches it, breaks a tackle, and Minshew's back to where he was after last game, picking up right where he left off. Second and one, play action. Looking for some options. I think we're going to go throw it to DeMarcus Holmes here. Stay in bounds. He gets 10. I mean, it is double coverage. I think we have the size advantage, and we do. DeMarcus Holmes goes up and gets it. What a season the rookie out of Miami has had. He's just been that go-up-and-get-it red zone threat target for us of late. He's been incredible once we've unlocked his full potential. We're going to throw it back to him. And he is almost dragged into the end zone. We are on the one here. And it might be time for an Aaron Jones score. Safety's coming up, though. Peoples might be open. We're going to audible out of that. And we're going to throw it. Did not mean to throw it to DJ Chark. Was looking for Dennis Peoples. Hit the wrong button. It was nearly terrible. I think an RPO could be really good here. And it is. Dennis Peoples, touchdown. The rookie with his 10th TD of the year. Third and three. I don't know if I like man coverage here. As that is open. Sammy Watkins showcasing the speed. Beats CJ Henderson. All right. Maybe they're getting something going here. Mahomes with all types of time, and just the speed of Tyreek Hill is way too much. Do we put CJ Henderson on him? Might have to. It's another run. Oh, we just tracked that way too well. Way too well. Third and 9. Almost seems like the Chiefs are running the ball a little bit too much on this drive. Hasn't been too successful for him. Third and 9. Just take away the throwing lanes. And he's going to the end zone. CJ Henderson doesn't react. I switched on him holding triangle, and he doesn't even put his hands up. That's an interception. Oh, that's crazy. The booth review is going to be ruling the field is upheld or stands. It's 14-7. Chiefs on the board. That's ridiculous. That should be an interception. We're going to throw it up quickly. People, just go up and get it. Oh, I thought he caught that. That would have been such a sick play. That's what you got to do against man coverage on the blitz is trust your best players. And Peoples, unfortunately, let me down a little bit. Quick throw to DJ. Nope, D.D. Westbrook. DJ Chark was up there. Chose to go to D.D. instead. All right, DJ Chark, we're going to streak here. He's either going to bring the safety up. Well, Dennis Peoples is open. Or he was going to get open if he beat press. But the dump down to Dennis Peoples was the move, and it was successful. Second and 10. Wide open is the rookie, DeMarcus Holmes, and he's got the first down, as that is the end of the first quarter. Pretty good first quarter for us. Honestly, should not even be 14-7. I don't think the Chiefs should have a point right now. CJ Henderson just did not put his hands up. I threw it right to him, dude. I thought he was coming down. I saw him. I just didn't think he'd be able to make a play on the ball. Juan Thornhill, nice play. It's a screen. He got rid of the ball so quickly. It's a broken tackle that's going to hurt more than it helped. They're going to lose quite a few. Third and 12. I got Lurker with Miles Jack now. That's a new superstar ability. Let me utilize that. Oh, nearly intercepted by Marcus Williams. He did well enough to force the incompletion, and the Chiefs will punt. No harm, no foul. Their punter looks to be quite young because he's not a real player. So probably a rookie, and he sucks. So I'd love for him to keep punting all day. He's not like me, not like the best punter on YouTube. Far from it. Second and 10. Beautiful touch pass to Dennis Peoples. I'm so pissed at that interception on that last drive. I think it was going for DJ Chark. Very frustrating. Peoples off the field for this play. And that's, oh my gosh, I just punched myself in the face. Juan Thornhill's second interception. Saw pressure coming in. I tried to get rid of it quickly. I was going deep down the left sideline, and then throw out of the sack. The ball just magically floats into the hands of Juan Thornhill, and I throw my second interception of the game. That one is unwarranted. The other one, bad decision, fine. That one was not deserved. Quick throw. CJ Henderson is beat. Oh my god, he broke a tackle. What version of Sammy Watkins is this? The one at Clemson? He doesn't play like this in real life unless it's week one. 44-yard touchdown for Sammy Watkins. I just didn't expect the broken tackle there. That was wild. Jones is averaging on only a few attempts here. 7 yards per carry. So maybe we should use him a little bit more. Thought he was going to break that tackle. But again, pretty much keeping up that average. Exactly keeping up that average. No way he caught that. I just forced that because I thought he would get separation. They're going to challenge. I mean, it might be coming back. I was so surprised to see him catch that. I don't think that left foot came down. I don't even know how he got his hands on it anyway. Yeah, that is definitely not a catch. So give me second and 10. That would have been crazy. Right, now we finally have Peoples on the field as our second receiver. We're in empty, probably going to throw him the ball very quickly. Didn't, but we're going to throw it deep down the field. Oh my gosh. Where's the inside lead there? That should be a touchdown, man. They're blitzing. Nice little run from Aaron Jones here. Broken tackle included. Second and 2. Barely able to avoid the sack there. Third and 2. People should be so open here. Do we get it to him? What a ball from Minshew. And Dennis Peoples has the end zone. What an effort. Every time we get him the ball, he continues to amaze me with the ways that he actually manages to stretch and get into the end zone. What a throw from Minshew, by the way. Incredible throw. And then Dennis Peoples to outrun everybody and reach for the pylon. Insane. I'm going to say it. Dennis Peoples is the best player we've ever drafted. Ray Stevens, eat your heart out. Dante Buchanan, eat your heart out. Dennis Peoples is the future. He's the current. He's the present. I mean, he's the past. He's the everything. Second one is the screen. What? Yo, why am I getting the freaking interception animation so early? That's a pick six. They're making me not get interceptions this game. This is wild. It's a run. Stop that well enough. Miles Jack, great stop on third and 2. Actually going to make this kind of a long field goal. They have Harrison Butker, I'm sure, as their kicker, who does have pretty good range. We'll see if he has it from here. It's a long one. 51, 52 yards. It is up and it is good. I don't know if he has it for much longer, much deeper than that, but Butker at least drills that one. First and 10. Don't throw the slant stupidly. Just check down to Peoples and watch him make magic happen. He's a freaking magician. Dennis the Menace. Go Jones. A nice little carry in there. And that might be his last carry because he is injured and holding something. Forearm maybe. Hard to say. Second and 5 though. That injury would suck if that's serious. because I'm not a huge fan of the alternative. I'm going to force it to Peoples. That time, it doesn't go how we want. Juan Thornhill, are you kidding me? Again, his third. Wanted to jump ball there. Didn't get it. Oh, and I'm back to my old ways. Launching picks. Sucking. Whatever. Oh, we're about to get bombed over the top. And Mahomes, the king of throwing deep, just checks down. And broken ribs for Aaron Jones. We should be getting him back for the playoffs, but that's a huge loss. The new starting running back is James Williams. And that's a user pick. Easy reads. One fish, two fish. Red fish, blue fish. I may have used that one super recently, but either way, it's an easy read. I could read that thing in a second. Maybe not that quickly, but a minute. Maybe not that quickly, but in a short amount of time, for sure. And there he is. Did I say James Williams? James Robinson. James Robinson. Gives Southern Illinois some respect. That's where he went. I don't want to just only force it to Peoples, but that's what this is turning into. When he's wide open every play, except for when I forced it and threw an interception to Juan Thornhill. It's a touchdown. Dennis Peoples, he launches it into the stands. Yeah, man, I got to stop throwing picks to Juan Thornhill. I thought that was blocked. I had no idea what the animation was. I thought I faked it at first. Would have been a crazy fake if it even faked me out. But no, it was nearly blocked. Whew, that would have been crazy. Big score, though, with 22 seconds remaining in the half. I think we can keep the Chiefs out of the end zone, though. Ooh, I don't trust this. We are getting out of man coverage, and we are not letting Mahomes bomb us deep. I'm going to call their final timeout. 7 seconds remain. They might have a shot at the end zone here. We're going to back up. Maybe blitz Ronnie Harrison. We have 4 deep zones. Let's just... yeah, they check down. I completely missed. But it doesn't matter, because they're out of timeouts. That's the end of the first half. Pretty good first half. I've thrown too many interceptions. Well, you already know, if Dennis Peoples is in the zone, I'm throwing to pretty much only one player. And it's D.D. Westbrook. Nice broken tackle. Now, I am going to force the ball to Dennis Peoples probably a lot. It's just something you're going to have to deal with or not. It's a drag. He will be open on the right side of the field. Actually, he might not be. But now he is. Minshew. Oh, he doesn't hit him. He sucks. That was a tough throw, but it was a throw that he needed to make. And he's out of the zone. How? I just targeted him. That's what it says. It's freaking... I hate that. Sick throw. DJ Chark, get down. Thank you. 2nd and 9. That's perfect timing on that. Peoples. Who else, dude? I don't have to defend it anymore. I'm throwing him the ball every time because he's amazing. 8 for 154. And I'm not stopping. Am I looking at any other receiver? Not really. I threw that away. Why did you not? How did he hold on to that? I hit it like a while ago. 1st and goal. I mean, who else would I throw to? We could have rack caught and probably had that easily. We want it in traffic. Dennis Peoples, touchdown. His 4th? Have I been throwing it to him that many times? It's only his 9th catch. I say only his 9th catch. It's his 3rd quarter. When you have talent, you gotta use it. All right? He's just too good. He has 4 receiving touchdowns. 3rd and inches. Get after Mahomes. And it's a run, and it's a pretty damn good run stop by Solomon Thomas. They do get over the line, move the chains, but that's a great play. Trying to take away everything. Sideline, Sidney Jones. Find the ball. I know he made a play this game to start it out. That feels like forever ago. I barely even remembered it. Make another play. What have you done for me lately? 3rd and 8. Oh, and that's nearly intercepted by Ronnie Harrison. Mahomes, I mean, he's got a good stat line other than the 2 picks, which you can't say other than because they happened. Only 7 incompletions, though. Dennis Peoples back to return. Give me a punt return touchdown. Is that even possible? It really isn't. You know what I'd love to do? Is give Peoples a big one-on-one shot down the field. That might not be this play. Ah, that would have been nice. I mean, it's 3rd and 10. I want to throw him the ball every play. I know that's probably going to get boring. But he's just, like, so good. 3rd and 10. I'm going to throw it to Peoples. And he catches it. He's got 95 catching. If I'm going to force the ball, I got to throw it to him. 23-yard reception. Here's the thing is, he was open earlier, and I pretty much waited until him to be for him to be covered. I want to give him a one-on-one because I know he can win down the field. D.D. Westbrook, though, is going to be the recipient of this pass, and he makes a nice move. He's always making somebody miss. Another run here. Good blocks. James Robinson, fight for it. Okay, and Kevin Pierre-Lewis is down. Dennis Peoples back on the field. 3rd and 2. This is not the time to throw it up to him as we're going to check back here. Oh, we're short. We are short of the line again. Jalen Reeves-Maybin made a nice play. We're going to try a field goal here. That might be wide right. No, it's not. It's going to stay in. 38-17. We have a good lead right now. But the Chiefs are one explosive play from getting right back in the game. So we can't let our foot off the gas pedal. Got to play some defense. Come back and score again. Man coverage against Darrell Williams here. That's not who it is. It's Damian. It's a good run. Allen on Mahomes. Oh, that would have been a super nice play. Instead, he dumps it down quickly to Tyreek. And there's a timeout. For what? It didn't look like there was an injury. I've never seen a yellow timeout pop up. I don't know why the clock would just stop there. That's a user pick! Easy reads! The Giving Tree! Is that Shel Silverstein? I think so. 8th pick of the year for Miles Jack. I lurked that so well. That's that superstar lurker ability. That is so fun. Peoples is super tired, but also, I trust him. One-on-one, he's just going to catch it. Rashad Fenton goes up and makes a play. Okay. Man, I tried. We had yellow stamina. I forced it. But I will give Peoples a one-on-one shot. I'm fine with the decision. I don't like the result. Should I be passing the ball anyway with this lead? No. Jordan Te'amu's in the game. So that was the injury. Mahomes is out. Jordan Te'amu, former Ole Miss QB, played with that big trio of DK Metcalf, AJ Brown, and DeMarcus Lodge. He was really bad. Because, of course, one of my big hobbies is watching tape on college players, you know, prepare for the draft. And I remember watching Te'amu because I'm like, man, the Ole Miss quarterback is super terrible. And it was him. He's going to run. He did that a lot at Ole Miss, actually. 10 yards. Just scrambles because he didn't want to read the defense. 2nd and inches. Let's send Chase on. Get Miles Jack in there. I tried to make it a nice little scrape there. Ooh. It's a nice throw and catch. He's going to run again. Harrison. Oh, man, I don't know how he got that slide down. He's going to run again. There's nowhere to go. Taven Bryan brings him down. He's got to throw the ball. You can't scramble every play. Our linebackers are too fast. I know linebackers didn't make a play there, but they are too fast as Sammy Watkins catches it again. Te'amu going to run again and slide in front of the hit stick from Miles Jack. That's his like thing. I guess his trait is paranoid. Because he is scrambling at the drop of a hat. 3rd and 6. Throw over the middle, and he's making Minshew look like an all-pro. 4th and 6. The Chiefs losing Patrick Mahomes probably lost them the game no matter what. All you have to do is put pressure on Minshew and it's over. And Schobert is in there for the sack. Quandre Sims gets half as well. We're going to take over. James Robinson, big carry. First and 20. Freaking hold from Andrew Norwell. Is Peoples going to be tired for the rest of the game? I'm getting that sense. Kind of disappointing there. First and 20. We're going to run here. Ooh, James Robinson actually gets us almost back to where we started. It's going to be second and 12. I think Peoples actually burned him. He certainly did. Big catch. Dennis Peoples. Four touchdowns, four picks. It's a 50-yard catch from Peoples, though. He's just too fast, and he catches too well. I might force him the ball again. I don't know what to tell you. Yeah. That's an accurate high point? Didn't look like it. Rolling out, looking for someone to throw it to. And we found him. Tyler Eifert, easy touchdown. That should be the dagger. Te'amu gonna run again. Oh my goodness, he got a block somehow. He really hasn't had that bad of a game. He's been super conservative as a thrower. He's missed some easy throws. But four carries for 30 yards. I believe he's like 9 for 11 throwing. For like 70 yards maybe. So not that great. And then interception as well. Yeah, 10 for 12, 68 yards and a pick. So he's been super conservative with the ball. But it could be worse, I guess. First and goal from the 9. Mahomes might be out a while. And this is a future AFC playoff matchup, potentially. So I'm cool with that. I mean, you never want a player to get injured, virtual or not. Second and goal from the 14 after the sack. Miles Jack is a pleasure to use as, I mean, Te'amu, he baited me. I was baited. Masterfully. Masturbated, you could say. Not a lot of time left in this game. 11 seconds from the 7. There's a flag. It's lobbed up, and it's... Ooh, I thought that was going to be a touchdown for sure. What is this flag? Offsides? Okay. I mean, he threw it right to me. Easy reads. User pick. The Lorax. It's the third interception of the game for Miles Jack. And we're going to have one play left. Probably should run the ball here. I know what you're thinking. But also, what if I threw it to Dennis Peoples? Nearly intercepted. Was going for Peoples there. Threw for 429 yards. Also, four picks. What a weird game. I mean, Mahomes was pretty good, but injured. Two picks for him. Two picks for Te'amu. Some user picks in there. Minshew, four picks sucks. A few of them were tough. James Robinson, decent game. Aaron Jones was good until he broke his ribs. So it looks like injuries are probably the story of the game here. Receiving, Dennis Peoples had 11 catches for 236 and four touchdowns. Other guys did get involved a little bit. Like between DeMarcus Holmes, D.D. Westbrook, and D.J. Chark, you're looking about 150 yards. But Dennis Peoples is a one-man show, other than the touchdown for Tyler Eifert. 11 catches for 236 and four touchdowns is a crazy line. Miles Jack had 17 total tackles. Three for loss, also had three picks, a sack for Solomon Thomas, a sack for Taven Bryant, half a sack for Schobert and Quandre Sims. Again, three picks for Miles Jack. Sidney Jones finally made a play. Had a pick six. Could have had more. Who even goes on the thumbnail of this one? Gotta be Miles Jack, right? So we do have some upgrades in here. Dennis Peoples. I need him to be... Why is he not facing us? He not face us? He's okay. He's playing up crazy because of his morale. Short route running being higher would be nice, but also, like, their drags, he's open every time on those anyway. I almost just want to get his spectacular catch up a ton. It's got to be deep threat for me. It's got to be. He's up to an 87 overall with Morales rookie year. Plus three awareness, plus one deep route running, plus one medium, plus one release. Release is good. Also, the biggest thing probably is his ability slot. Release is up to an 84. His ability now is short out elite. Receivers with this ability catch more consistently while catching passes less than 10 yards from the line of scrimmage outside the numbers. I hate that one. I almost never throw those types of plays, those types of routes. That's a terrible one, I feel. Should we re-roll that? Yeah, I'm going to say you guys are probably going to ask to re-roll that in the comments. So I'm just going to go with it. And that might actually hurt his other attributes. But sometimes that's just the way it is. It might change his abilities. That's okay. Also, it might be fun to see Dennis Peoples overall at running back. Just because he is so good. He is so good after the catch. 88 overall. So if we needed a running back, here's Dennis Peoples. We don't, I mean, because he's such an amazing receiver. What would his ability be? Truz, grab and go, and playmaker? Man, Truz, the worst superstar X-Factor of all time. Like, yeah, they don't fumble anyways. So, like, who cares? Okay, so new abilities from Peoples. Kind of fun to mix it up anyways. He's got Ankle Breaker, which I guess he didn't have that before. Truly devastating receiving threats are the ones that catch and can't be caught. When they enter the zone, they have increased fake-out rates on spin, juke, hurdle after the catch. Kind of similar to, what, Yak Him Up? That's a fun one. He has Energizer, which he had, and then Deep Out Elite. Receivers with this ability catch more consistently while catching passes 20-plus yards from the line of scrimmage outside the numbers. So it is Deep Out Elite. But that, what if we streaked him and he's outside the numbers? Like, I wonder if that would work as well. So I will try it out. I'm all up for experimentation here. So I think we're going to work on getting CJ Henderson's zone coverage up now. He's so great as a man corner, but we need to play more zone. Ooh, plus one speed. I'm in. Plus one press, plus one zone. Decent. 94 speed on CJ Henderson now. The CPU can handle the rest. No, not Casey McDermott. Anyways, that is going to do it for this video, guys. Thank you so much for watching. This was a fun one. Dennis Peoples is the best player of all time. And injury report says that Aaron Jones is out for the next 5 weeks. So week 15, 16, 17. He might be able to come back for the wild card. But I'll see you in week 15. We got the Texans again, Patriots, and Colts to end our schedule. Thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoyed it. I'll see you the next one. Take it easy. See me high step to the end zone. My life like a game Nintendo. Playing with the best, let them know. Get off the track, the train's coming through. Yeah. Promise you get in my way, then you best believe I'ma just run over you. Yeah, yeah. Mama turn taking it back to the house. Defense a joke, I'm laughing so loud.